All right, welcome to Tracing in Inkscape with Mr. Burkell. I have here Inkscape opened up, and we're going to jump into learning how to trace a little penguin. So, first thing that I did was I imported an image into this document by going to File, Import, and then finding the image that I wanted to import. Once that was in there, I put it on its own layer, and I locked the layer so that I wouldn't draw on that layer, and then I changed the opacity down to below 50% so that it's still visible, but I'm able to see the stark contrast of the black lines that I'm drawing on top of it and see it very easily. Then I created a third layer, a traced body layer, which is where I'm going to start with my tracing. Now, for our tracing, the tool that we're going to use is the pen tool, also known as the Bezier tool. So you're going to click on that, and when I start tracing my images, I start with a very rough outline. All that I do is I click and let go, click and let go, click and let go, click and let go, and do it a couple more times until I've got a very, very rough outline of the image. Now, as you can see, my rough outline doesn't look anything like the penguin itself, but you'll see how that will start to change as we start manipulating this basic shape that we've created. And we're going to do that by jumping to the Edit Paths by Node tool, which is located right here. Now we'll click on that tool, and we'll go to our individual nodes. Now each of these points is a node. And you can see that if you click on them, you can move it around. You can get rid of them by hitting the Delete button, Control Z to undo. You can even add by double clicking. The first thing that I'm going to do is take this node up here, and you notice it comes to a point. And you'll notice this penguin does not have a pointy head. And so we want to round that out. So the way that we change that pointy node to a smooth node is we hold the Control button and click on that point. And now he's become rounded, and that node has some handles that I'm able to move and adjust if I want. Now I'm going to hold off on adjusting those because you see that it's smooth over here also. So I'm going to go ahead and smooth those sections out. We've also got some points over here in which we could probably add another node. So I double click and then move it to where I want it to go. Double click and move it to where I want to go. And then it's pretty smooth down here also. So control click, control click. And that's our rough outline of our penguin. And we can start manipulating the shape by starting to move the individual node handles and nodes themselves. So we'll come like this. That matches the bottom very well. This area is done pretty well. We can maybe even bring that in just a little bit. There we go. Let's see, it looks like we're having some funny stuff going over here, so I'll add an extra node and bring it up there. Same thing here. And then we can bring this node handle in just a little bit, as well as this one. And you see, with just a little bit of adjusting and a little playing and tweaking, you get the exact shape, or pretty close to the exact shape, of our penguin. I'd say that's pretty good. Once you have the exact outline or as close as you want, you can then select that object and color it by just hitting one of these buttons down here. Then you can go ahead and add a second layer onto that and start doing the exact same thing with the inside of the body. We can take this and we can hide it so that you don't see it anymore. We can add a new layer, and it's going to be the inner body, lock the trace layer, and then we can do the exact same thing that we did before using the pen tool to mark the outline of the shape. And then use the node handle, or select nodes tool, to start adjusting our shape some more. And you continually do this over and over again, adjusting the positionings of all of our points, making it the shape that you want it to be. And that is how we adjust and trace using Inkscape.